Okay.
Somebody's going to have to tell me who everybody is.
Well, no, we're going to move this, Dad. Yeah. So right now you're seeing all of the folks that, I mean, you can't see them very well, but you can see all the people that have come to join you right now.
Oh, my goodness.
Two big screens of people.
Okay.
Isn't that neat?
Isn't that wonderful? I can't believe that. The only thing is I can't see the people.
Okay, well, you will here in a minute. We're going to change the view a little bit.
They haven't heard me from me yet.
Well, they can hear you right now while you're talking.
Oh, they are. Okay. Hello. Yes, I know who that is.
Yeah. So we see Dick Manning right now.
Yeah.
On the big screen, the big wide screen.
Hi, Dick. That's wonderful.
Hi, Les.
Hi. I've already heard your lovely or wonderful enchanting voice already today, son.
Are you talking to me?
Yes, I am. Hi, Roger. Oh,
hello, Les. Since you recognize me, I think I'll take the opportunity to kick this off. Is that okay with you, Kent? I'm going to assume it is. Can you hear me, Les? Yep.
I can hear you fine, Roger. That's wonderful.
Okay, well, great. Well, we're here for a very special event, as you know, and we appreciate you taking time away from your family for this week-long recognition of this significant milestone in your life to be with your classmates here. So we're looking forward to talking to you and hearing what you have to say as well. But I'm going to take an opportunity here just for a few introductory remarks and then turn it over to Kent Williams, who's going to be moderating the activities this afternoon. But what I wanted to do was, in just to taking the privilege of being the first to wish you happy birthday from the class, I wanted to just say a few things about the new class structure, which we've adopted since the last time we were on a Zoom call with you. I know you followed it, I think. We have a new board of trustees, which we set up to manage the affairs of the class going forward as we age. We're going to, you never age, Les, but we apparently do. So we need help to manage our affairs. And we've been done a pretty good job for 60 years on this ad hoc, with your support, procedure of getting volunteers for reunion management, for raising class funds, for getting a class correspondent, for just a whole variety of things. But it was felt that we'd reached the point where, in order to manage our affairs through the remaining years of our lives, that we needed a better structure. And so we put together this board of directors, a board of trustees, I should say. And I want to, I think you know who they are, but I'm going to announce the names, particularly for the members of the class who have not been as closely tied to this procedure as some of us have. But the volunteers that were elected as the first board of trustees were Ralph Anderson, Bill Carr, Lloyd George, Andy Horsey, Doug Thiessen, Kent Williams, and Donna White. I think I've got everybody there. And we wanted to have one spouse represented, and Donna was the one that was elected. And they've been off and running for a couple of months now. I think October was the first meeting. And I want to thank them, first of all, on behalf of the whole class, for stepping forward to do this important work for us on behalf of the class. And to say, it's exceeded our expectations, I think. They're meeting regularly and doing really good work in managing what we need to keep our eyes on in the future. So thank you all. And with that, I'm going to turn it over to Kent Williams, who is the coordinator, the chair. I'm not sure what we're calling him, but he is... been managing the calls with the trustees, and he's agreed to lead the this call with you, Les, as the MC. So I'll turn it over to him.
Okay, Mary, do you have to change the screen, or am I on it?
Yep, you're on it. You're good.
Okay. Well, my job is the one that nobody else wanted, not the trustees. And on behalf of all the trustees, and thank you, Roger, for recognizing them, I want to thank all these classmates for attending this Zoom call. It's quite a turnout for in honor of Les. Also, I want to thank the High family in San Diego for joining us and letting us into your home one more time, into Les's home one more time to recognize him. And also to Jerry Kane, let's think the master of the Zoom and our host for today on this call. And Les, what a special day it is for all of us. Les High is 100 years old and a day, okay? We get you in your second century, all right? I like that. Okay. I'm sure yesterday was very special for you and the family with the family celebration there in San Diego. And now is a chance for us as a class to celebrate with you too, okay? The trustees wanted to do something special on behalf of the class. And everyone likes a present for their birthday. And Les would like one too, I'm sure. So we've done something to recognize your milestone birthday by funding something at the new Coast Guard National Museum in New London, Connecticut. And on behalf of the trustees, Lloyd George took the lead on this effort. And so let me turn it over to Lloyd to give you a little bit more of an idea of what our recognition is for you on this, your 100th birthday. Lloyd, you ready?
Yes, sir. Thank you, Kent. And it's good to see all these faces, especially Les and your family. The class has actually purchased a stone for our class, and it'll have an inscription. It'll be installed at the museum. And we thought that in honor of this great milestone, I mean, how many classes get to see their class advisor at 100? I can't believe that anybody else would have an opportunity like this, and we're really blessed. So we decided to cast another stone right next to ours for Les and for all the work that he's done for us. And I'm going to flash it on the screen now so that you'll be able to see it. And I think that Jeff and possibly Kathy may have with them there the actual photo of the engraving. Do you have it?
I have it in my hand, young fella.
Well, let me read it so everybody
have it in my hand.
All right. Excellent. Well, you know, as you can read it, or it been read to you, I'll just read it aloud. The class of 1965 honors Les High, class advisor, on his 100th birthday, 12 February 2024. And that will be installed at the museum right next to the paver that is installed and acquired by your guys and your gals. And so we're very honored to be able to do that. And it'll be there until the museum is overgrown, if that ever happens, God forbid. So happy birthday to you. And we want to recognize this in a kind of our own down-home way with a little jingle. Happy birthday to you.
Wonderful. Nobody gets it from every state in the United States, but Les High, and he's got the class of 65. Thank you.
And Barbara and I just wanted to slip in our congratulations right now to make it easy.
Happy birthday, Les. It's a joy and an honor to be with you today.
Thank you, sweetheart.
Thank you.
Good to see you, Barbie. And thanks, Lloyd. That was wonderful. I really do appreciate you doing that, okay?
Okay.
Now, Les, the rest of us were sort of lip syncing that because it turns out when you do a Zoom call, it's hard to have 40 or 50 people all singing on the screen at the same time. So Lloyd and Barbara took the lead on your family in San Diego. But I also want to give credit to Greg, your son, who found us that music snippet to be able to use, okay? You don't know how hard it is to find Happy Birthday without somebody else's name in it, okay? So, Happy Birthday to you.
Thank you very much.
That sort of takes over the class proceedings. And now we thought, gee, maybe as a surprise, Les would like to say something to the class. So,
is it going to be my turn?
If you're feeling up to it, now would be your chance to make some remarks in the second 100 years, okay?
Okay, all right. I'll think of some words here. Let me see. What could I possibly say? Good to see you, Jerry. But anyway, I'm going to start off with, this is so typical of what you guys have been doing and your one of the ladies for 62 plus years. And of course, Carol and I are just sitting here and just sucking this up by the ton because nobody ever gets to hear people singing from every state almost in the United States. And that's what you just did. I am in awe of all the things that have been happening to me on this 100-year thing. But I'm really very much impressed with what my family's done and what the class has done. It's gotten me lots of wonderful things. And I want to thank you all for all you do. And certainly thank you for the plaque in the museum. That's an unbelievable honor. Someone goes, hey, who in the dickens is this guy? Well, the class of 65 made this guy famous. So, hey, we're going to put you in the museum. Thank you very much for honoring me on my 100th birthday. I'm really looking forward to talk to whoever wants to talk to me in the next few minutes or whatever we plan here for today. I'll be available to talk to anybody that wants to come forward. Thank you guys and gals for just being so wonderful in Carol and my life. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you, Les, for those remarks. That's very nice. And if we weren't all muted, we'd be applauding, okay?
Yeah, okay.
So pretend that you hear us, all right?
Okay, I did.
And now we do want to open it up to the floor. I guess, Dick Manning, you're going to control that part of it for us?
Yes, sir, I am.
Okay.
And I'm going to control it by starting off. So mute yourself, Kent. I wanted to say that for decades. If you would please mute yourself. Wow.
You have to pay me to mute.
I love it. Les.
if this is our turn, Admiral. Then Jerry and I want to say happy birthday, Les, and looking forward to many more of these occasions. And I will mute myself so others can talk.
Okay, now that Kent is muted, I'm going to start off. And I'm going to thank you, Les, on behalf of the 50-plus members of your family, all the dozens and dozens of people in your neighborhood, and mostly for the class, because you have been a treasure to us for most of your 100 years. So thank you very much for that. And I'm going to call on some people, and if they would unmute when I call on them, they will have the screen. And if I don't hear them in a few seconds, I'll just go on to the next person. So we're going to start off with Bill.
Yeah, Les, I just wanted to wish you a very happy birthday. And also for Carol and all the ladies, happy Valentine's Day. Lou and I are dressed to go out to a Valentine's dance and dinner tonight.
Yes. You know,
do you remember back in 2010 when Dick was doing the presentation of the book Roger related to me that you went through the book shortly afterwards to count how many times your name was up in the book. You remember the number?
I don't remember the number. I really don't.
All right. It was 65.
Okay. Okay. I was going to guess 65. But okay, good. That's the way.
And at this point in the project for the MCOE alcoves, I counted things up last night, and guess what? There's 65 less vignettes in the library for all the class. But anyway, wonderful to have you around for so long and for your 100th birthday.
Thank you very much. That was very nice. Very nice. Is my mic?
Yeah. Okay. Yes, it is. You can. Yep.
Okay, fine. Thank you.
Happy birthday, Les from Prairieburg.
Thank you. Okay.
Enjoy your dance.
Oh, I will.
Lady, you have the floor.
I found the unmute button. Technologically challenged as I am, Les, happy birthday. It's great to see you looking so good.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for the greeting. Good to see you. Okay.
This technology is really a challenge for us old folks. Carl Hellman, you have the floor.
Captain High, you are too marvelous for words. God bless you.
Thank you, Paula. Thank you, sweetheart.
Happy birthday.
Thank you very, very much, Carl. It's wonderful. I'm going to greet the people I can really see. I don't see very well. So if I call your name, fine. If I don't call your name, I just can't see who you are. Okay, thank you. Good to see you guys. Thank you very much for your nice comments. Okay.
Steve Cox.
Thank you very much. Hey, Les, happy birthday.
Thank you very much.
I did want to say one thing is that you are as old as Gershwin's Rhapsody in Blue. It has a birthday too today.
Wow.
And so I thought you'd like to know that.
Absolutely.
There's two wonderful things that have birthdays. And again, from Carolyn and I, most happy birthday and many more.
Bill Norris, please unmute.
I think I'm unmuted. Happy birthday, Les. I have an important task, and that is to also wish you happy birthday from Judy. And she made me promise that I would do that as she had to leave this morning. She would have loved to have been here if she could have been. But in any event, have a wonderful happy birthday. And as others have said, many, many more. Love you much.
Thank you, Bill. That's wonderful. And tell Judy hello. Give her a hug for me, will you please? I really do enjoy having personal contact with you guys, whether it's by phone or by Zoom or whatever it is. I love it. Let me tell you. Thank you, Bill.
Well, we love it too. And you're an inspiration to all of us.
Thank you very much.
The other thing I was going to say for the other people, happy birthday from sunny California. I don't think the rest of the country has.
Thank you.
It's having such
Thank
a good time.
Good Thanks, job, Bill. Good job, Bill.
Thanks.
Tom Pennington.
Les, happy birthday. We had our chance for an early one. And we thank you again for the hospitality you showed on the 10th of January. And we beg you for a repeat next January on our way back on our way to Sydney. What a good time we had.
Thank you so much. We just had a great time sitting there talking and listening to all your stories and reminiscing. And it was wonderful. We just love you so much. And happy birthday.
Thank you, Tom and Fady. I don't know whether the crowd knows, but these lovely people came to visit me in January, and they probably were going to come for an hour, but I had the door locked 3 hours, and they didn't get out. So I got to have their wonderful company for 3 hours, and I want you to know I really did enjoy every minute we had together. And you can come anytime you want, and this goes for all the rest of the class, as far as I'm concerned. You can come and visit anytime.
Thank you, Les, and thank you for the 62 years for locking those in.
Thank you. Thank you.
Love you.
Wonderful to hear from you, and glad you had a good time in Hawaii, guys.
Yes, we did. Thank you.
Okay, bye-bye.
Jackie Wright is next. Jackie?
Is that better?
We got you. Got you.
Okay. I can't hear you, but I was just thanking Les for encouraging us to support each other, and we've really appreciated that camaraderie that he has worked so hard to keep us going. Happy birthday.
If you can't hear me, I'm sorry, Jackie, but you're one of my heroes, sweetheart. I appreciate all the things you and Jim did for me. Going to my award ceremony and so forth. And you did a marvelous job of taking him care of your husband. So be proud, young lady. And you're just a typical sweet, sweet, sweet heart of the class of 65. Thank you very much.
Thanks, dear. Thank you.
Joe Rogers.
Okay. I know Jackie's a tough act to follow, but I'll try it. Les, on behalf of Candy and myself, and all us folks back here on the East Coast who don't get a chance to see you in person very often, I'd like to wish you a very happy birthday, many happy returns, and hoping that we'll get out on the West Coast one of these days and be able to drop in person. Thank you.
Thank you, Joe, and thank you to Candy. I'm sending Candy a hug. I don't know whether the class knows it, but Candy used to get phone calls from me all the time. I'd be calling up Roger Roof, and I would jump the list, and it could go up one, and I got to the Rogers, and of course, Candy got to answer the phone. So tell her I'm sorry. I'm on the ball nowadays, and I don't make that mistake, Joe. But that was a fun thing to do, and I've always enjoyed talking to your wife. Okay, and
Candy, always enjoyed talking to you, and not when you thought that it might be Barbara, but more. And she misses it. She definitely misses it.
That was just a thing for the rest of the class to hear about, but we had a lot of fun with it, didn't we, Joe?
Yes, we certainly did. Absolutely. Thank you.
That's for the class's entertainment. You guys are going to find out there's lots of stories that this old guy knows about with individual class people, and I'm probably going to share some of them with you today. I hope if they get too boring, just tell me to stop, okay?
Take care.
Okay, good, Joe. Thank you.
John Schwartz. Wake up, John. Okay, let's move on to Bill Riley.
Bill Riley here, Les.
Hi.
How you doing? I got Jeannie here, too. Come on, Jeannie.
Wonderful. Go.
Can you see Jeannie?
Yes, I can. Thank you, honey. Good to see you.
Happy birthday, dear. You look wonderful.
You,
you look great. You don't look a day over 80.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
Les, it's a wonderful thing to have reached that milestone. And I'll never forget that it was your positive attitude and your association with your family and your extended family and things of that nature that got you there. A little bit of clean living, too. So, Les, God bless you. God bless your family. And God bless the class of 1965.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Well deserved. And I say the same thing, Bill. Thank you very, very much. Good to see you, Jeannie.
Okay? You too, honey. You take good care now.
I will. And you take care of you. You take care of each other, okay?
We always do. Thank
okay,
you.
Good for you.
Happy
good
birthday.
Bye-bye.
I just had a good suggestion. Jim Morgan and then Rick Steinbaugh is on deck. So, Jim.
Hi, Les. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Okay. Well, it's Eric Steinbaugh here. I'm in the mountains in the south of Brazil on an overlanding trip with the Land Rover Defender. We're going through Argentina, Chile, Paraguay, Bolivia. And I just wanted to thank you for instilling in all of us the thirst for an adventure. And I think that if you look at the things that the class has accomplished, everybody had that thirst. And I think everyone will agree that you were the source of it. And I also wanted to wish you a very happy birthday and remind you what George Burns said on the occasion of his 100th birthday. He said, "I hope the second half of my life is as rewarding as the first half has been." God bless.
Thank you, Eric. And it's good to know you're traveling like that. That's very exciting for us. Some of us are sitting around home doing nothing but talk to wonderful people. I got to do that. Good to see you. Thank you very much. And have a good trip, young fella. Okay.
Thanks for the wonderful appreciate birthday. It,
thanks for the birthday greeting, son.
Hey, Bill Simpson, and then Andy Horsey's on deck.
Les, this is Bill Simpson and Donna Duffy. We wish you a happy birthday and raise a glass to you.
Love you so much, and thank you for all of your mentoring and love. And we can't love you anymore. We want to give you a hug.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, you guys. It's wonderful to see you on the screen, and thank you for the wonderful greeting. It's always good to talk to you. Thank you very, very much.
Chip Morgan, did you want to say a few words?
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Oh, great, great. Hi, Les. Happy 100th birthday. I don't think you can see me, but
no, I can't. But that's all right. I got you.
That it's been so wonderful. It's been so wonderful getting those Christmas calls and letters from you for all these years, and I want you to know that I'm looking forward to getting your 100th Christmas call.
I got to make a few more before I get to 100. Sorry, hey Jim.
Thank you so much for all you've done, Les.
Okay, thank you very much. Good to see you,
Andy Horsey. Then Bob Lukerts.
Les, I think it's very clear that you are more alert than the rest of the bunch of us. So happy birthday from Ann and me. We wish you the best after this 100th birthday plus a day. You and Carol have meant so much to us and to our class over these past actually 63 years. And we thank you for your leadership. None of us would have been the same without you. May God bless you. Thank you, Les.
Andy and Ann. That's just so nice. But you guys are just all so wonderful. And thanks for taking the lead on many, many, many things, Andy. I love your hearing about your golf program and all the people. I love to do that. But you run the things that have to do when we have people passing and so forth. So thank you. But I appreciate your wonderful greetings on my 100th birthday. And your lovely wife, I hope she can hear that I appreciate her. And it's always wonderful to hear her on the phone when I'm trying to reach you. But that's the way it goes. The wives have to put up with me, too. I'm sorry, but that's the way. If you're going to be married to one of those guys, you got to put up with that class advisor. So that's the way it goes.
Well, thank you. I think she wants to talk to you as much as I do. So there you go.
Thank you, Andy. Thank you very much. Wonderful comment. Appreciate it. Okay?
Thank you.
Hey, Bob Lukerts, and then Rod Roof.
Yes, Captain. Hi, I want to wish you the best for your 100th birthday. Julie and I appreciate all that you've done for the class through the years, and always enjoyed the phone calls and the letters and all of that that we look forward to every year. God bless, and again, happy birthday from both of us.
Thank you, Bob and Julie. I don't know whether Julie can hear this, but you guys are I love talking to your household because I get to talk to Julie. Sometimes you're so busy, you're doing something else. So just tell Julie she has to put up with me, because when I want to reach you, she may have to be the one that hands the phone off to you. So thank you very much, and thank you for the wonderful greeting. And I'm glad to hear things are going relatively well for you in Michigan. Thank you very much. Okay.
And Raj Roof, and then Angela Orecki.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Les. A second opportunity. Can you hear me now?
Yes, I can.
Second opportunity to say happy birthday to you. And I can't top the greetings that others have expressed to you. We just love you so much and appreciate so much what you've done for us over all these years. And can't say any more than that. We were blessed to have you with us all those years, and to be behind us and giving us the leadership that we so valued that you provided to us.
Thank you, Roger and Barbara. That's wonderful comments from your household. I'm not too sure that I come anywhere close to what you guys are describing, but I'm glad you think my leadership was good and Carol was inspirational to you people. And so thank you very much for the nice comments and the nice birthday greetings. I'm sending my love your way, okay?
Okay. Angelo and then Howard Newhoff.
Happy birthday, Les. As I look at these screens and see all these wonderful people that I've known for all my life, or I think it feels like all my life, I thank you for what you've done to hold us together. I think we're the only class in the Academy's history who has togetherness like we do, and you're responsible for much of it. Happy birthday.
Thank you, Angelo. That's wonderful. I'm glad to hear you're doing well and very nice remarks. I'd like to take credit for holding you together, but this class had an aura about them that, when we, the first Christmas, when we sent the letter out, and 80% of you responded, that was an indication right at the very beginning that you and your wives were going to stick with that old guy and his wife. And when we had a nice tour at the Academy, and it just says, here we are, 60-some years later, having a wonderful life together. Thank you for your nice comments, Angelo. Thank you.
Hey, Howard Newhoff, and then Donna White.
Happy birthday, Les. It's hard to believe that we're our age and you're your age, but we've made it this far and we're going to make it a lot further. It's been a wonderful ride over the last 60-odd years, and we love you very much, and we wish you nothing but the best in the future.
Les, I'd like to say hi to you, and I think that you're the star that resonates brighter than all the other stars, a true leader, a wonderful man, and we love, love the letters. In fact, our granddaughter was following some of your letters, and she also said a happy, wonderful blessing of a birthday. So happy birthday.
Thank you, Holly and Val. It's wonderful comments, and it's good to see you got some of the kids looking at some of our. It shows a wonderful relationship we have in life. And when we have this wonderful relationship, the other people can see it. So thank you very much, Howie and Val. I'm sorry, Howard. I get that wrong sometimes, but you've been too close to me for so many years. You're going to be all you. Whether you want to be.
He changed it. He changed it.
You accept that. Okay. I got to remember, I'm 100 years old. I get a chance. I can have excuses for making mistakes. Thank you. Okay.
You're welcome. Love you.
Love you.
Okay, Donna White, and then Doug Thiessen's on deck.
Hello.
Donna.
Hi, Les.
Hi, Les.
It's so nice to see you looking so well. And just blessings to you for this milestone in your life. Jim and I have always enjoyed receiving your letters, and I have received your phone calls and enjoy that as well. So many more years of good health to you, and I hope to talk to you again soon. Happy birthday.
Thank you, Donna. Thank you very much for your nice comments. I've always enjoyed seeing you and Jim. And since even now that Jim has been gone, I remember the last couple of times I was in New London, you actually to the Navy Lodge just to see Carol and me, or just to see me. And I appreciate your kindness and love. Thank you very much, young lady.
And love to you as well. Take care.
Bye-bye.
Blessings. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Doug Thiessen, and then Wayne Becker's on deck.
Hi there, Les.
Hey, Les. Happy birthday. And it was great talking with you the other day. And I hope you haven't consumed all of those 100 chocolate kisses that Phyllis sent you. But I want to say that what is being recorded here should be required viewing for any class advisor going forward at the Coast Guard Academy. What you are doing is responding to each and every one of us in context with, with an acuity, if I could use that word, that is marvelous. Good health going forward, and happy birthday, Les.
Happy birthday, Les. I'm getting ready to package up another 100 kisses.
Well, I want to tell the class that this one, thank you very much for your comments, folks. That was wonderful. They sent me a package of 100 kisses. And I hardly talked to them. I had eaten half a dozen of them. But thank you very, very much. That was a delightful surprise and a delightful gift. But that's just scratching the surface. It's so wonderful to be able to talk to you. These two people that they always acknowledge, Carol and I, when we came to New London, when he was running the Mystic Seaport, he took me on a tour and invited me to meet all the people. And I enjoyed that every time, Doug. So thank you very, very much. I've always enjoyed you. Thank you very much, guys.
Happy birthday, Les.
Happy birthday. We love you. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Love you.
Okay, hi, Les. Thank you to you and Carol. God bless you.
Is that Wayne?
Yeah.
Okay, I don't see very well, son, but
that was it.
I'm sorry I haven't gotten back to your email you sent the other day. I just haven't gotten to it. I have been a little bit busy with the society here in San Diego acknowledging it. I have a 100th birthday. Like yesterday, even the Coast Guard threw a helicopter over my house in honor of me. So that was nice. Good to see you, Wayne. Thank you very much for your greeting. Okay?
Lori Summers.
Go ahead, Lori.
Okay, Les, it's great to see you looking good. And it's great to see our classmates on today with you. That's so special. Carol and I continue to derive tremendous inspiration from you, and we're looking forward to a lot more.
Hello, I lost you for a second, but I heard about you and Carol being there together, and I see you, and you look good, and thank you very much for your nice comments. Keep going.
Just a little story to tell you. It's got this painting of the eagle, beautiful painting. We had a commission when we were in Monterey. We couldn't afford it at that time. And the story was about being under full sail on the Eagle, headed to Europe as a cadet, and there was a storm coming in. And the captain decided to shorten sail. And so I was sent up to the T'Gallant, and some of our classmates were sent up to the Royal, and we were trying to shorten sail before that storm hit. Well, we didn't make it. We hit in the storm, and we got the sails furled and back down on deck safely. And I was trying to remember which classmates were up there with me, and up on the Royal. So if anybody could chime in on that at some later time, I'd appreciate it. And what I remembered about that was that we didn't do a very good job of furling that day. There were some dead men laying along the yardarm. Our cadets will remember what that meant. And I have to admit at this time that whole thing scared the crap out of me. But I think I was a better man for it. And, And so that was one of the remembrances I have whenever I wander through our living room.
Thank you, Lori. That's a wonderful story. And the class is going to really enjoy hearing that because and thank you very much, Carol. It's good to see you. Everybody will enjoy these stories right off the top of our head. And so thank you very, very much for that.
Have a happy birthday.
Thank you very much, Carol. It's good to see you.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
John Schwartz, are you there? Is there anyone else that would like to speak?
Successfully unmuted myself. Penny and I just want to wish Les a wonderful, wonderful continuing birthday on to however many days you want to make it. Wish that sunny and sometimes snowy Virginia was closer to where Les's home is out there in beautiful sunny San Diego. But we hope to see you on one of our trips out to the West Coast soon. But happy birthday.
Thank you, John. It was wonderful. Penny, good to see you, Penny.
You okay. Too.
Thank you very much, and thank you very much. I'm sorry to see you in a neck brace, but that's obviously something that you didn't want to have.
I was going to point out that's not a clerical collar.
okay.
In case anybody was wondering.
Anyway, I'm looking forward to your coming to San Diego and for a visit if you haven't had to go this way, because I know you do travel. So, hey, you know, the airplanes do fly west too, you know. So
absolutely.
Okay, absolutely. So thank you very much. And it's good to hear from you. It's wonderful to hear from you. Thank you very much for your greetings.
That's the end of my list. Jerry Kane, did you want to say something?
Hi, Les. Yeah, I haven't talked to you in quite a while. I am in California, so I have no alibi for not getting down to see you. So you're just about 100 miles down the coast. I hope to make it in the next month or so.
Okay. Well, good to see you, Jerry. Thank you very much for your comments. Appreciate it. It's been a wonderful show, son. This is really, thank you for all your work to make our togetherness even more together. That's what these Zoom sessions have been, absolutely wonderful and fabulous. And I think everybody here on the screen, starting with Manning and all the way down that have been involved, are going to say that these are wonderful, wonderful togetherness things for us all. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. It's great when the tech works. It doesn't always.
Good to see you.
Is there anyone I missed?
I didn't sign up, but I want to talk. This is Tony Finizio. Hi, Les. You know, having left the Coast Guard earlier than most of my classmates, you and Carol did the most to keep me involved with the class, and I really appreciate that very much. Roa really enjoys getting your calls every year. It's been a fantastic 62 years.
Thank you, Tony and Ro. I don't know whether Ro's there, but anyway, tell her hello for me, and I'm sending my love to you guys, and thank you for your wonderful greetings, and thanks for your calls. When you get a chance to call me, you know how much you can tell when you talk to me. I hope all the class can tell that I really do love talking to the class of 65, and Tony and his family, they have an interesting story that I always felt was very interesting. I remember when you were first married and you had three boys, and Ro was wanting to have some girls in their family. And so the guys were a little late in getting married, and then they married these wonderful wives, and then they started having kids. And instead of having boys, they had girls.
very true.
Girls. And I don't know whether the rest of the class knows that. I'm telling little stories out of school here, Tony. I hope you don't mind.
But not anyway, a problem. What's funny about that is watching the sons handling girls after growing up in an all-boy household.
Well, anyway, it's just the sort of thing that when you've been with a loving group like this for 60-some years, you're going to know a lot of little individual details. I remember at the last dinner class reunion I was at, you guys sat at my table, and so I got to see you and Ro right across the table from me. So there's just the memories go on and on, and this not only for your family, but all the rest of the class. If you may notice, this guy remembers little things about every one of you wonderful, loving people. And so you have to put up with my stories because you've made me a loving fan. That's what you've done. So thank you very much to the class of 65, and they're absolutely beautiful, wonderful wives.
I think we have to thank you.
Dick, I'd like to say a few things. Don Jensen.
Oh, hi, Don.
To wish you a happy birthday. You found the key to a long life, or the many keys to a long life. I'm guessing that staying physically active with your walks around the block, your neighborhood, and also keeping mentally active with all the emails and all the interactions that you have. I'm just wondering if you might have a few other factors that you could share with us, keys to a long life.
Keys to a long life. Well, I've got one that I always, you guys gonna know about. I had a perfect wife. Carol was a perfect wife for me. And so basically I was gonna be a winner regardless. And then when we got to the academy and you guys selected me a class advisor, had a wife that loved doing the job as much as I did, maybe even more than I did. I don't know. She just loved being a chaperone for the class. So you may wonder why we were with you so much at the academy. And of course, our togetherness at the academy put us together forever because you were just warm people who made Carol and I feel very wonderful and important. And so when we left the academy, we missed you. Missed you, truly missed you. And so we wrote to you the first time and you all responded. So here we are together, 62, almost 63 years later. And that's wonderful for all, certainly for Carol and me. We love it. Thank you.
Happy birthday.
Thank you very much, Jensen, for them Jensen. That's wonderful. You good to see you both, Becky.
Dick, if I could.
Anyone else?
Yeah, Dick. Bob Scobie here. Yeah, just a quick comment. Shirley, a very happy birthday to you. Last week, Ditsy and I have been so lucky to have your supporting behind us. Just a quick story. When we had an MCO e-meeting, somebody mentioned how their advisor went to most of their meetings. They obviously didn't go to your meeting, so you would have made sure they went to all of them.
That'd be a great deal.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much, Bob and Ditsy. I don't know whether Ditsy's there, but thank you. And one of the nice things about this particular couple, I got letters from them every year. They each wrote a letter. So I got two letters. Thank you very much, Bob. And give Gitsy a hug for me, will you please?
I sure will. And I apologize for the noise outside. They're redoing our roofs.
Okay. That's all right. I got to see you. Thank you very much, son.
Last call.
This is Bill Phillip. Is he available?
Les? Hello. This is Bob.
Bob State.
I want to apologize for not getting down there in February like I usually do, but I will be down there before the year is out.
Good for you.
We're in cloudy, rainy Oregon, and I just finished selling my house in Vegas. So we'll be going down to see my daughter in California in a couple of months, and I will be swinging by, and I'll let you know. So I'm sorry to miss your birthday. Happy birthday.
Good. Thank you very much, Bob. I appreciate it. I don't know what the class knows, but this guy has been coming to see me almost every year. He used to live up in Los Angeles area, right near Disneyland. And then he used to come every year. Then he had a son that was on a Padre baseball team. But anyway, Bob, I appreciate all your visits. And don't worry about whether you missed me a month or so. He also sends me tons of cookies, folks. I might let you know. He sends me a box before he comes, and he sends one after he comes. And but anyway, thank you very much, Bob. It's good to see you. And come anytime you get a chance, okay?
Les?
Yes, hi.
Hi. I hope to see you soon, and wish you a happy birthday. And as a class advisor, for some reason, the other night I was thinking of the time at the academy when we got our officer's swords, and we had a place on there to inscribe our names. And I remember a number of classmates decided it'd be cool to put something in Latin related to blood killing or whatever. And the kibosh was put on that. And I assumed that it was you. Do you remember that?
I'm not going to take the blame for that. But it probably was me.
Yeah, okay. Well, yeah, well, you saved us once again from being soporific and, you know, having officer swords that related to being an officer and a gentleman. So, Les, you know, we're all old. There's no doubt about it. But I just wanted to give you a sign here to show you that we can be hip. I think you'll understand this.
I'm sorry.
I managed to wrap my gnarled fingers into that. I hope you understood.
Okay. Thank you very much, Del. And good to see you. Good to talk to you. And good to see you. And I want you to class to know that Dell's been in close contact with me. He was a class correspondent, of course, that you had to put up with a class advisor if you're a class correspondent. Sorry about so much of that time, but we've had a lot of good times together, Dell. So thank you very much. Okay. And hopefully everything's going well with Cordelia there, and she's doing well as possible. Okay. Good to see you. Thank you for your comments.
If I could make one other comment, our girls wanted to be remembered to Les. Our oldest daughter, Christina, whose oldest son is the subject of my essay in the Gift of Leadership book. Our daughter, Michelle, who met with you and Carol and in Reston at Jeff and Kathy's home when they were living there. And Anne Marie, whose husband met Roger a few years ago at the cast presentation in Washington. So they all want to be remembered to you, and they all remark every time we talk about our class and about you. They all want to be remembered for all of the wonderful things that you have done for us and for what the class means to Barbara and me.
Thank you, Lloyd. Thank you. Thank you, Barbara. Thank you. Nice comment. Thank you.
God bless you. Have a wonderful rest of the day.
Thank you very much. Well, it's nice to hear when the rest of the family down the line is still knowing about our relationship. That means the relationship we have between Carol and I and the class means so much to family. And when it means something to the family, it goes on and on and on. And our good relationship for 60 years is not bad for society to see, because we are a loving, loving, loving group. And it shows. Take a look at this Zoom today. Look at all the fun you've given me to have a chance to talk to all you guys. And Carol's sitting right here telling me what to say. So I love this. So thank you very much, Lloyd, for your comments. Good to see you, Barbara. Good to see you. You take care. Thank you.
Les, happy birthday. Ginger and I, Ginger and I love you. You've been such an inspiration to us. And you have a lot of fans out there besides class of 65ers. I was talking to one of them the other day, Jim Loy, and he wanted me to express his happy birthday wishes. We all love you, and keep at it. As I said, you are just a great inspiration to us, have been for all this time.
Thank you, Jim. That's wonderful. And Ginger, I don't know whether she's there, but let make sure she knows that I appreciate you both. Jim and Ginger have been inspirational. And one of the nice things about Jim and Ginger, they send me copies of their family pictures, and they've done it every year, and they document them well, so I know who their kids and how they're growing. So thanks, Jim. That's always been wonderful, and thanks for all your wonderful and inspirational talks over the years, and I'm glad you appreciate that I do something that made you guys a better life. Good to see you. Thank you very much, Jim. Good to see you.
Les, it's my sad duty to say we got to bring this to a close unless you have some more words, and they've been a lot of great words today. I want to give you one more happy birthday, though, from the Coast Guard Academy Alumni Association. They've asked for a copy of this Zoom event, and they may try to pick some things from it and sort of recognize your 100th birthday in the alumni bulletin or some way. I don't know how they're going to do that, but we will send them a copy, and I'm sure they can find a lot of rich material for whatever they want to do.
Well, that's wonderful. Thank you very much, Ted, and thanks for running this program. And just one more comment to the class. I had some local people come to my house yesterday, and the local Coast Guard people flew an airplane over my house just to honor me. And then this morning I got a nice letter from the commandant of the Coast Guard thanking me for being 100-year Coast Guard veteran and commenting about some of the things that I was able to achieve in my Coast Guard career. And of course, any success I had in the career was caused by Carol helping me be successful. So she's the example setter for us all, and she's made us all be closer and closer and closer. So thank you all for wonderful, wonderful greetings, and thank you very much, okay? Is that where you, Wayne? Did you want to say something else?
No, goodbye.
Okay. Well, less than you certainly taught us. There's two key things that were in life: family and friends. And we've taken those lessons, I think, to heart. And thank you to your family for helping host this on the San Diego side. We really do appreciate that. Thanks for all the classmates for showing up. And unless Roger has a closing remark, this will bring the Zoom call to a close today. Happy birthday, and many, many more.
Thank you, Kat. Thank you very much. And I do have a fabulous family. They're right here with me. So I want you to know that, okay?
Thank you. Yes. Applause. All right. Anybody else? Otherwise, we'll close the Zoom for another occasion. Bye-bye.
Okay.
Thank you. God bless.
God bless.
Thank you. I'll send a link to the recording of this out to the whole class and to Les. Next time.
Thanks, Jerry.
Yes, it's
over. Yeah, we're just going to build it.
One by one, they will leave the screen. So we're just going to watch.
Kind of watch. Okay. Everybody's leaving.
Okay, great.
Yeah. I'm waving.
Yeah.
Oh. Waving. Goodbye. Oh, people, you could wave too.
Yeah, you can wave.
Mascot is here.
Good to see you. Good to see you.
There you go. They're all waving.
They're waving.
Okay.
You're not muted, then. So.
Yeah. Okay, you can
okay.
talk.
Okay, well, good to see you all. Lots of noise. That's wonderful. I have really enjoyed this all. Every one of you.
Yeah, that was great.
That was
great, guys. who was that?
That was great.
That was great.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know if I'm even in my.
there's Jeff.
Okay, okay.
Bye, Dad.
Bye. Bye. Dude, somebody there. Is that Greg?
That's Greg. That's Greg. Waving.
Okay.
We got on the video, by the way.
Is that Jerry up here?
Yes. Jerry's got to be last man out.
Okay, okay. That was a great show, Jerry. I don't know whether you can hear me, but
yeah,
that was absolutely, I really enjoyed it. I hope it showed how much I enjoyed that show.
Yep. Take care. We'll see you your next birthday.
Well, good to see you. Good to see you.
Hey, Jerry, just because you do a lot of this technology, I'll let you know that this is Jeff. Greg's taking a video of the big family thing or the neighborhood thing. We had about 150 people here yesterday. And it was really significant. So he's putting stuff together as he does, you know. So yeah. I'm sure he'll be sharing it.
Yeah, if he shares it with me, then I can put it up on the our class site. So that'd be great.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay. See you later.
See you later. Bye, Les.
Thank you very much, Jerry.
Welcome.
Bye-bye.
Saying hi, Jerry.
Howdy.
And then I'm Mary, and Dad'll be in, you know, when we get to 1 o'clock.
Okay.
Getting our setup done and making sure it's all ready to go.
Right.
So I'll go mute us again.
Okay.
Okay.
Hello, Jerry. This is Carl Hellman and Paulette.
Hi, Carl. Hi, Paulette.
You're not showing me, dear.
Well, you told me.
Hi, Jerry. How you doing?
Good.
Hey, Dick Manning.
Yeah, it's hard tracking, but I see you, Dick.
Okay, yeah. I'm going to be keeping a list of potential speakers. Anyone that wants to speak, please raise your hand, and I will acknowledge that you're on the list. And when we need someone to say a few words, and the emphasis is on few, we'll start off. So I've got Bill Carr.
Hey, Bill.
Come on, guys. This is audience participation. I know Lloyd George wants to say a few words, so put your hand up, Lloyd. Okay, we've got Lloyd. Okay, I've got Paul Blaney. Is that a hand, Paul? Okay.
Where is Paul?
Carl Hellman, if you don't say a few words, I know Paul that will.
Yeah.
Thanks, Carl.
Hello, we're here.
Hi, Paulette. How you doing?
Good, thank you.
Good. Okay, so I've got Bill Carr, Lloyd George, Paul Blaney, and Carl Hellman. Steve Cox, is that a hand I see? Thank you, Steve.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you. Yes, I heard you.
Good. Okay. Yeah, I'd like to say just a quick few words.
Hey, Orbit.
Okay, that's great.
Hello, Jerry.
I know Kent Williams is going to want to say a few words. Kent, the emphasis is on few.
Unaccustomed as I am to speaking in public.
I will put you on the list.
I will have a master of ceremonies role, and you will need to put me on the list. On behalf of the trustees.
No, we're not going to do that. We know better than that.
Tom Pennington from outer space.
Oh, there he is.
That's the usual.
Hi, Carl and Paulette. Jerry's going to be here soon.
All right. Super. Looking forward.
Bill Norris, you want to say a few words?
Sure, I'll say a couple words. Unfortunately, my wife.
Okay.
She has more words than I do.
Okay, Tom Pennington, I know you'll want to say a few words.
Is everything okay? Okay.
I got back in just in time to hear my name, but I missed the rest.
Yes, Tom, I'm just volunteering you to say a few words.
Okay, remember I visited Les and had Faye and I had a long conversation with him, so few is the watchword.
Oh, few is the watchword, absolutely. We're going to try to keep Kent to few, and if we can keep Kent to few, I think we'll be able to complete it within the allotted time.
There's Jackie.
Uh-huh. Jackie, you want to say a few words?
Kyle lives on the East Coast now.
Okay, Jackie, you are muted. So if you want to say a few words, just raise your hand. Thank you.
How do you get her on?
And Joe Rogers.
Hello, how are you?
Can we get a couple of words from you?
Sure. I just wonder, I was looking for all my classmates, but there's a bunch of old people on here and I have no idea who they are. So,
let's look in the mirror.
I mean, I do recognize some faces. I see Carl and I see Bill Norris and... Oh, yeah. Lots of folks I recognize. Good. I'm here.
Good. I only recognize Carl because Paulette looks so young.
I understand. Yes.
Yeah, anybody else?
Dick, are you...
It says on...
Dick?
Yes, sir.
Are you keeping track of how many people will be logging on? Might be a nice number to have for Les to know how many people are joining him on this Zoom call.
I'm keeping track of the number of speakers. I think when we do the look at the recording, we should see 49 faces per page. So we can share that with Les.
Okay,
but,
thank you.
Keeping speakers. You know, I'm a single tasker. I'm not a multitasker. So I'm just going to keep track of the speakers.
Okay.
Yeah. And Zoom.
And since it's more than the number of fingers I have, I'm absolutely overwhelmed.
Are you missing a hand?
Tom, you should have had this job.
You're doing great.
I think you should say,
John, you don't hear me? Okay.
John Schwartz, welcome.
Welcome. Hello.
I assume you're raising your hand to go on the speaker list. Is that correct?
Oh.
Thank you.
I guess I'm on a speaker list now because I raised my hand. I'm only seeing like four faces across the bottom plus yours. So is there a way to increase the number?
You have a choice of speaker view or gallery view, and that should be up in the, I don't really see it. Jerry, can you help me out?
Yeah, it's up in the upper right-hand corner. Up, screen, should
upper
say.
Right-hand corner, if you move your pointer there, it'll click on view.
Yeah.
Yep.
And then you get gallery.
Oh.
Okay.
And we'll have more than
Under more, maybe.
If you go under view and select gallery. I'm going to check next to gallery.
Yeah, it's actually on my screen, at least, views in the upper right-hand corner of my screen.
Here? No.
Oh, well.
Okay, who hasn't had a chance to volunteer? Jim Morgan, would you like to volunteer to say a few words to Les? Just nod your head since I can't see you, just your name.
I'll volunteer.
Thank you. I see that was Bill Riley that volunteered.
Yes, Bill Riley was volunteering.
Bill Riley and Jim Morgan. Okay.
And by the way, if Jerry's around, thank you, Jerry. It was a hard pull, but I'm here.
Bill Blanchard. You know,
we owe a lot of thanks to Jerry for making this whole thing happen. It was not an easy task.
Right. We'll see how it goes. But as I mentioned, Dick will roll all of this together. So let's just have fun.
Bill Blanchard here. Can you hear me?
Yes.
I need some technical help. I'm not seeing my own image here.
Yeah. there's a on my screen, there's an arrow left and right where you can page the views of the participants in the gallery. Do you see that, Bill?
Well, yeah, I do, and there's a square for me, but my face is not in it. I'm looking right at the camera, so I must
have. Oh yeah, I can see that. Have you? Is your camera blocked?
I don't think so, but maybe I blocked it in some way I didn't realize.
Or did you?
Down in the left, lower left-hand corner, there's a stop video. And okay. If you've got a line through the camera, that would keep you from.
No line through the camera.
Yeah. Are you on a laptop where there's a toggle at the top of the monitor to open or close the camera?
Well, it looks, it looks like there is. Just a minute.
There you go. Yeah, now you got it.
I didn't know that was there. This is a relatively new laptop, and I never saw that before.
That's exactly what happened to me. I used the post-it note till I got this new one. I realized it was built in.
That's pretty cool.
I like it better without your face, Bill.
Well, I don't blame you.
Okay. Any more volunteers for the speaker list? I'm on the first page. Rick, Rick Steinbaugh, would you like to say a few words?
Yes, I could just say a few words. I'm here in Brazil. I'll just tell Les thanks for instilling adventure in us.
Absolutely. That's a great thing to do. Let me get to the second page now. Okay, I'm on the second page. Anyone that wants to volunteer to speak that's not on my list, please raise your hand. And we'll start with Bill Simpson. You want to speak?
You're on.
Yeah. Okay, thank you, Bill.
There's Bill.
I just hope I can read my writing. Orvis, how would you like to speak? Oh, okay. Say a few words.
Yes, he would like to speak. He didn't know he was.
Orvis would like to say a few words. Okay, that's great.
No, I don't have anything to say. We're good.
Ralph Anderson, don't have you on my list. Would you like to speak? Raise your hand.
I'm fine. On, I'm Ralph, fine as I am. Thank you.
Would you like to say a few words to Les when he shows up?
No, I sent him a card. That's enough.
Okay. Andy Horsey, would you like to say a few words? Okay, you're muted, but I heard that, and there's nothing better than having a lawyer muted.
I can't see you.
Bob Lukerts, I don't think you're on my list.
Sure, put me on the list.
What do you say? Okay. Who is MBSTO?
Hmm.
Is that Bob Storch?
Mary and Bob.
Okay, Rod Shroof, I know you want to say something, so I'll put you on the list. You don't even have to volunteer. Skip Onstad, would you like to join the list? Raise your hand if you'd like to join it and say a few words to Les. I can't hear you, Skip.
I think they're recording.
We'll need to see that, hear that your microphone. Okay, you are now muted. So please unmute yourself, and we'll try again.
Nope, not yet.
You need to unmute yourself in the lower left-hand corner. Okay, because I still can't hear you.
Yeah, so he's unmuted, but
Yeah, you know, some of these microphones just don't work. Angie Recchi, can I put you on the list? Raise your hand if you want to join the list. Thank you, Angie. Anyone that I missed?
This is Howard. Can you hear me?
Yes.
I can hear you.
Yeah, would like to be on the list.
Okay.
By the way,
is the iPod Doug?
I think so.
Sorry?
Doug often shows up as iPad. I can't tell if that's him or not.
It's interesting how people show up. I see Bob Lucret says RTL. It's like somebody I want to salute.
I'm a Zoom user. How do I get out of that one?
Jerry?
same way you got in.
I don't know.
Donna White, would you like to say a few words to Les when it comes time? If so, please raise your hand. Boy, if I could read my writing, this would be a lot easier. Okay. We have yet another page.
Smile, Joel. Joel Rogers, smile.
I am smiling, can't you tell?
It's all that facial hair.
You should have seen it before I got a haircut.
Okay, I've got iPhone phone 12 Pro Mac. Is that Don Jensen?
No, that looks like Carl, maybe?
Whoever... You're muted, iPhone 12 Pro Mac. Lower left-hand corner, you can unmute.
Can that do it?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, who is it?
This is Carl Hellman and Paulette. We have a power failure in the neighborhoods. So I'm on my cell phone now.
Wow. Well, let me just go through the pages again. If there's anyone that would like to speak that has not had a chance to get on the list, please wave your hand in front of the screen. And I'll go through all three screens and see if I got any waved hands.
Doug's raising his hand.
Okay, any waved hands on this screen? I think we've got everyone. The last screen, Doug Thiessen, do I have you on the list?
Why don't you put your phone out?
I know. Okay, I know you want. Yeah, you're now on the list.
Finally got unmuted here. Hi, Jerry. Thanks for this.
Yeah, that's going to be a real challenge. If you're not heard after about 10 or 15 seconds, we're just going to go on to the next person.
That's fine.
Did he hear us?
Yeah, I think so.
And you thought there was no need
to come up for. Priscilla, how you doing?
I'm fine. How are you, Fred? Miss you guys.
Yeah, that we had some fun on Governor's Island.
Yeah, that was a fun time. Priscilla, over and out.
Yeah, I could tell a quick joke. When Doug was selected to be my new boss, in all seriousness, I asked Phyllis, what should I call her? I mean, here's the admiral's wife, and I'm a mere deputy. And without hesitation, she said Priscilla. And it's been Priscilla ever since. That's a true story.
Yeah, that's exactly right. It's called She Who Must Be Obeyed.
No, I wasn't that.
Tom Lucy said she was the real admiral. And I couldn't agree more.
Let me just read over my list. I've got Bill Carr, Lloyd George, Paul Blaney, Carl Hellman, Steve Cox, Kent Williams, Bill Norris, Tom Pennington, Jackie Wright, Joe Rogers, John Schwartz, Bill Riley, Jim Morgan, Rick Steinbaugh, Bill Simpson, Orvis, no last name needed, Andy Horsey, Bob Lukrich, Raj Roof, Angie Recchi, Howard Newhoff, Donna White, and Doug Thiessen. So if you're not on this list,
you ain't speaking.
Skip, can I hear you, Skip?
I guess
so. Okay, you're not muted, but your microphone's not working.
I see a pillow.
Okay, Dick, that would be probably Faye. I'm sure she won't come and not speak, so she'll be here later.
Is that?
Faith. Okay, I will add Faith to the list, Tom. Thank you.
Dick, I don't know if you have Wayne Becker's name on the list, but I thought I noticed him trying to raise his hand. But Wayne, I may have that wrong. I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's right.
I do not have Wayne Becker on the list.
Well, put him on.
Where is he? Wave his hand.
Yes, sir. I'll add Faye. And Wayne. And this is just our attempt at making this to be an organized chaos.
Dick, do you have Kent on the list?
With an asterisk next to it.
We all have that.
I get twice the allotted time, Andy.
Yeah, if we have any time left over, we'll allocate it to Kent.
Yeah, if anybody wants to yield their position, I'll be happy to take it.
Andy, it looks like you're still living in your car.
I am. It's not that bad.
How far did you have to
drive? I see Bob Storch now. Bob, if you can unmute and say that you would like to be on the list to speak to Les.
I got a question for Jerry. Jerry, are you going to dub in the background music or am I going to use my phone? Jerry, you mute?
Yeah, I think you should just use your phone, Lloyd.
All right.
It's going to work fine.
beautiful. Stop.
Can I have a minute of everybody's attention, just please, that before we start, to help? We got a little agenda. We're going to give a welcome. We're going to do, Roger's going to do that. We're going to welcome Les and the family. We're going to give him a commemorative gift. Lloyd's going to take care of that. Then we're going to sing happy birthday, except we're not. Because of the limitations of Zoom, Barbara and Lloyd George will sing happy birthday along with the people with Les in San Antonio. The rest of us will be muted, and you can lip sync along, but that's as good as it's going to get. All right. And then after that, we're going to go back, ask Les for his comments and remarks. And then after that, we will open it up, and Dick and Jerry will allocate your time to say a brief, think about it. There's about 30 of us who want to speak. So you have about, you know, 15 seconds, 20 seconds to make your happy birthday wishes. That way we'll probably get this thing done in about an hour, maybe a little bit longer. So unless there's something wrong with that, that's the format we propose to use this afternoon, okay?
Now I've got 25 speakers, Kent.
Okay. I can't do the math, but it's more than a minute to 25 minutes. We're trying to keep it to about an hour, a couple reasons. Les might get tired. And the other thing is, and we're also going to bring you on one at a time, because his vision problems, he can't bounce among these screens as we can. And so we've got whoever's going to be wishing him happy birthday is going to be full screen for him with nobody else there. So that's why we're going to coordinate the greetings. So to make it easier for Les.
Yeah, he will be on the speaker view. So he will only hear those that are unmuted and speaking. If there are three or four of you unmuted and speaking or have noise in the background, it can be very confusing. So please be muted until you are given the floor.
Seems to me that some of us have never been muted in our whole lives, but
that's a good comment, Joe. You know, imagine if we had a mute switch when we're on active duty. What a deal that would be for staff meetings.
It's funny.
People would have paid a fortune for that.
Is that similar to
Is that Bill Sigler? Man.
Oh, you have two screens.
What could go wrong? I'm just saying.
I think you need to turn the phone off.
Is this a surprise?
Where is it? Yeah. Lori Summers, would you like to say a few words? If so, please raise your hand. Thank you. This is Jim Andrasik, would you like to say a few words later on? If so, please raise your hand. Okay.
Excuse me, Dick. This is Jeff. Can you guys hear me? Audio test?
Yes.
Okay. You tell us when we want to bring Les in here. So he's ready and standing by when you guys are ready. Okay.
Well, it's 12:59. Like Kent, as the master of ceremonies, are we ready?
Yeah. If other people want to join us as we go along, but we've got a good representation from the class. Let's go ahead and make it happen.
Okay, I'll go get him.
Ruffles and flourishes.
They're just starting. So.
And this is a good time to mute yourself until it's your chance.
How do I do that?
Where do I do
that? Just
lower left hand corner. Just click on mute.
Run over. Right, Dad, you're going to figure out where your seat is.
I can find it.
You have to move this out of the way when I get out of the way, okay?
Okay. There you go. And just spin yourself around.
Okay.
Here we go. Okay.